All right, and we are live. Welcome, everybody. Today, we are going to talk about how to stop being reactive. Does it happen to you that you have certain behaviors that you feel are out of control, whether it's worrying all the time, whether it's anger, whether it's checking social media? This is what we're going to talk about today. But let's start with presenting myself. My name is Nick Redmark. I'm a Swiss coach engineer. And what does an engineer do? An engineer solves problems and builds tools that solve those problems. And what I'm doing is applying the engineering approach to personal development and bringing you personal development tools or tools that you can use in your personal development every day in these live streamings that you see right now. But let's move on. So let's talk about reactivity. What is reactivity? Why are we reactive? Why does it happen that we act in a way that is out of control? This term has a more scientific term, which is called conditioning. How does conditioning work? There is this famous experiment by Pavlov. I don't know, it's maybe 100 years old, that we have to kind of understand and look at. So, if you have never heard Pavlov's experiment, it works like this. You bring food to a dog and the dog starts salivating. But at the same time, whenever you bring food to a dog, you ring a bell. And over time, what happens is that the dog starts salivating when you ring the bell, even when you don't bring the food. And this is called a conditioned response. Now, for human beings, it's more complicated than that. Because let's say, for example, you see that you have a notification, that's a stimulus. That's not the whole story. What happens is that inside your mind, there are certain thoughts and feelings, and within your body, there are certain sensations that emerge. And all of these can become stimuli. So it's not just the external thing, it's all the thoughts that you have and all the feelings that you have that can trigger a certain behavior. So let's look, for example, at this situation. If there's someone who insults you or says something that you don't like, and then what this person said is in your mind and it makes you worry. What happens is that when the person is gone, the triggers keep being there inside your head. And so the insult, you're basically bringing the insult back to yourself again and again and again. And this is what triggers long-term kind of out-of-control behavior. So what is the answer? What can we do? And the answer is mindfulness. Now let's bear with me, I explain you how that works. So you have to understand how conditioned reactions work. So there is a stimulus, and then what you feel is an urge. And when the urge becomes big enough, there is a reaction. You react to the stimulus. What happens usually is that you are not aware of the urge. It's something that happens within your body somehow, and you don't even know that it's going on. If you practice mindfulness, meaning you pay attention to your physiological reactions, then what you see is that you can observe the urge as it becomes like a wave. It becomes stronger and stronger and stronger, and you can break that link to the reaction because you just observe, and the urge then fades and goes away. And then when the urge is gone, you are free to choose how to react to the stimulus in a different way. So mindfulness is something that in everyday life, it's hard to practice. So you need to prepare a space in your day where you can practice mindfulness, and that's basically what's called mindfulness meditation. So every day for 10 minutes, just sit down and pay attention to your feelings and to your thoughts. And if your mind wanders, you just go back to paying attention to your feelings and your thoughts. The idea is to train, not reacting to whatever is going on. And what the result of that is that then while you are in daily life amidst many other people, you can still with open eyes just pay attention to those internal feelings and emotions and thoughts. And so I really recommend you practice this 10 minutes a day. There's no need, especially at the beginning, to do much more. Between 5 and 10 minutes, think of it as something that you will do the rest of your life, that you will teach your children, like brushing your teeth. It's just something that should be a part, a stable part of your life. Don't see it as a kind of a career to become the best meditator in the world. Just as, like, if you are not an athlete, you still should work out. So if you don't want to become a saint or a monk, but still you want to kind of have this little bit of control over yourself and practice that, so just meditate every day. And I recommend that you use a meditation app, especially if you are not have not practiced it. And there are these two apps that I have used. I'm currently using the Waking Up with Sam Harris, because it's a kind of a it's a very interesting type of meditation. It's not just about mindfulness, but the Headspace is perfect for the Headspace app is perfect for beginners. So I really recommend you download it. And that's it about mindfulness. This is just basically, I'm really planning to do this every day. Every day I come to you with a tool that can help you in your personal development. Sometimes we have problems that are specific to us, and there, if you really like encounter a problem that you kind of cannot sort out, then I have here an offer for you, which is 1 hour free coaching, and you will already get some benefits from that, and we can discuss maybe a continuation, but this first hour is free. Thank you very much. See you another time.